Hi, now we'll be doing the topic accounts and record. It's covered in your section 35 and section 36. These are super simple sections. Section 35 simply says that you have to maintain a list and details of the accounts of your inward supplies, your outward supplies, the tax, the inward tax paid, okay, your how many goods you have manufactured, the details of your supplies, how much credit have you availed, how many goods do you have, how much output tax you are liable to pay, and any other particulars as may be prescribed. So who has to maintain this? Every registered person has to maintain a proper books of all the details with respect to the goods and services. This, what if I have a place, more than one place of business? I could have 10 branches. So do I need to maintain the records at every single place? Answer is yes. So when there is more than one place of business, the accounts related to each place of business shall be kept at such place of business. So if I have a Bombay branch, I have to maintain all the records of Bombay branch there. If I have a Delhi branch, I'll maintain all the records of Delhi branch in that place. That's what they're saying, that when you have more than one place of business, the accounts relating to each such place of business shall be maintained at such place of business. Then the next question comes up, that if do I have to store it in physical form or electronic form? Answer, it is up to you. Even electronic records are considered to be as valid records. So every registered person may keep such accounts in electronic form as may be prescribed. Obligation of the owner, of the operator or warehouse or a transporter. Now we have seen the obligation of every registered person, that is the person himself should maintain all the list of all the accounts. Now we are talking of the intermediaries, could be warehouse keepers, transporters, etc. Okay, who store the goods for the suppliers. Even they need to maintain the records of what? They will have to maintain a record of who is the consigner, the sender kaun hai, receiver, consignee kaun hai, kiske liye hai, buyer kaun hai, other relevance of goods as may be prescribed. So every owner of a warehouse or a godown or any other place where the goods are used for storage of goods, irrespective whether he is a registered person or not. So every person, even if he not registered in the in GST, he will have to maintain the records of how many goods are being stored with him, it is for whom, and to whom it is going to go. So the buyer, seller, and the details of the goods will be maintained. So these are all very simple stuff, very less chances of these coming in the exam. Additional accounts and can be maintained. The commissioner may notify a class of persons who need to maintain certain additional documents. Relaxation and maintenance of records, where the commissioner feels that any class is not in a position to maintain accounts, he may, for reasons recorded in writing, permit such class to maintain accounts in some other manner. Again, not important. Now this is important. There was section number 35, subsection 5, which has said that the accounts of audits was required. Now with a amendment act in 2021, Finance Act 2021, this section 5 subsection 5 has been omitted. Okay, so now audit of accounts is no longer required. It just casts the additional burden or additional cost onto the suppliers, and now since it is, everything is automated, separate auditing is not required. The government has provisions of general audit. Wherever they feel that it has been suppressed, then they can conduct an audit. Here it is not mandatory for all, as section 35 subsection 5 has been omitted. Now, no accounts of goods or services is considered to be deemed supply and it is liable for tax. Section 35 subsection 6 is covering cases where the supplies are unaccounted for. I have made purchases and I say mere paas mein sales ki koi entry hai hi nahi, main dekho mere paas mein koi bhi invoices maine maintain kiya hi nahi hai. Ho sakta hai ki nahi? It is possible that a dealer might not maintain any accounts, or he might have said mere sab books gum gaye, mere jal gaye hain, mere paas mein available hi nahi hai, delete ho gaye, it has been destroyed, etc. Now, what do? When you know that so many goods have been bought, but we don't have details of its supply and it is not even in existence. So, we will consider ki bhai aap hum log assume kar lenge, it will be assumed, deemed that you had made a supply and GST on those unaccounted goods will have to be paid as if it was sold. So, if you don't have any accounts for the goods or services, then it is deemed that you have supplied, collected the tax, and that much with respect to that, you will have to pay the GST. For example, if goods worth 50 lakhs were unaccounted, okay, unaccounted sales. So, iski details hi nahi hai apne paas mein 50 lakh ki. So, tumko lag raha hai government bolegi, achha, theek hai, sales ki detail nahi hai, to nahi liya hoga. We will say, we don't know, you haven't maintained. इसके ऊपर 12% जीएसटी आता है, इसके ऊपर जितना भी जीएसटी पेएबल है, वॉट एवर इट इज, ओके, यू विल बी लायबल टू पे फॉर दैट. सो यू विल बी लायबल टू पे फॉर दैट. हाउ मच इट कम अप टू? सो इट कम्स अप टू 6 lakhs. सो 6 lakhs रुपीज आ जाएगा जीएसटी पेएबल. नाउ मूविंग अहेड टू रिटेंशन ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स. फॉर हाउ लॉन्ग डू यू हैव टू रिटेन दीज रिकॉर्ड्स? नाउ अगेन इट्स सुपर सिंपल. द पीरियड ऑफ रिटेंशन ऑफ द अकाउंट्स. अगर मैंने अकाउंट जो भी है मेरे, आई हैव मेंटेन्ड एन अकाउंट, फॉर हाउ लॉन्ग डू हैव टू कीप इट? कैन दे कम एंड टेल मी दैट 10-15 साल पुराने डिटेल्स लेके आओ, अगर नहीं हुए तो हम आपकी इसकी स्क्रूटिनी करनी है. तो देर विल बी अ टाइम गैप, टाइम लिमिट टू मेंटेन दीज रिकॉर्ड्स फ्रॉम द रजिस्टर्ड सप्लायर्स एंड ऑल्सो. इवन इट शुडंट कॉज अनड्यू हैरेसमेंट टू द डीलर्स वेर दे आर आस्क्ड टू मेंटेन रिकॉर्ड्स इनडेफिनेटली. तो टाइम लिमिट दिया है कब तक करना है. तो ये एवरी रजिस्टर्ड पर्सन हु इज रिक्वायर्ड टू मेंटेन द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स शैल रिटेन देम फॉर, ये उसका समरी है. तो दिस यू कैन टेक इट अ नोट एंड दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑल्सो. सो फ्रॉम दिस एंटायर सेक्शन 35-36, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट, द पीरियड ऑफ रिटेंशन. सो लेट्स रीड इट अप. इट लेटर ऑफ द टू पीरियड्स तक रिटेन करना है, 1 year आफ्टर द डिस्पोजल ऑफ सच अपील रिविजन एक्सेट्रा, और 72 months. 72 months सिंपली मीन्स 6 years, okay, from the due date of filing the annual returns, whichever is later. So let's read it up. क्या है? तो या तो 6 साल तक maintain करना है from the date of furnishing the annual return. Annual return अभी किया, यहां से 6 साल रखना है, या फिर 1 year after the disposal of the appeal, whichever is later. For example, let's read it up first. This section, that is section 36, covers the period for which the accounts have to be retained. Normally 72 months is there from the date of furnishing the annual returns for the period pertaining. So normally it is 6 years, but if it has gone in appeal or there is a revision or there is some court dispute, okay, litigation with respect to that, then it will be, we'll have to wait for the litigation ka answer also. So 1 year from the appeal or 6 years from the furnishing the annual returns, whichever is later. So now let's take an example and you tell me what will be the answer. ठीक है? Appeal ये 6 years तक मैंने maintain, 6 years था, और appeal था, appeal was disposed of 7 years. 7 years from the date of furnishing the annual return. तो कौन सा apply होगा? 6 साल for annual returns से, let's say annual returns से 6 साल हो गया, बट फिर भी अपील चलती रही फॉर अनदर 1 year. तो वहां से लेके 1 year, जब भी ये अपील डिस्पोज ऑफ हुआ, लेट्स से यहां पे अपील एंड हो गई, तो अपील से प्लस 1 year लेना पड़ेगा. तो विच एवर इज लेटर. लेट्स टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल. लेट्स से यहां पे मैंने फर्निश किया एनुअल रिटर्न्स. अब एनुअल रिटर्न जैसे फर्निश किया, यहां पे ही डिस्प्यूट अपील चला गया और डिस्पोज ऑफ हो गया. सो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, ठीक है. नॉर्मली 6 years तक तुम्हें मेंटेन करके रखना है फ्रॉम द टाइम यू फर्निश द एनुअल रिटर्न्स. लेट्स से अपील यहां पे ही आके डिस्पोज ऑफ हो गई. इन द फर्स्ट ईयर ओनली अपील, फर्स्ट ईयर में ही आके डिस्पोज ऑफ हो गई. सो विच वन आई टेक? 1 year from the dispose of the appeal, मतलब सोचो second year तक, or 6 years from furnishing the annual returns, whichever is later. तो answer will be this. If in another case I came to know that the appeal was disposed of in the 7th year, then we will say boss 7th year mein disposed of hua plus 1 year, that will be the delay. So whichever is later. So it's a very simple provision and nothing difficult. Okay, and that is it. We are done with this section.